All right, good morning to you. It's Wednesday, we got action. Kodak's looking nice. Anything up above this pre-market high 1277 will be a buy for me. I will wait, see if there's some liquidation at the open before I take a trade. HMNY, looking good pre-market, broke out of this flag, pushed up to 1040. Now it's coming back to test this previous resistance. If it can hold up as some new support, that will be a buy area as well. And AMRH. This thing has gone up pretty much $4 in the past hour. You know, it was what, 560, 540. Now it's all the way up to 985. So it definitely has to pull back a little bit before I get in there. I'm not going to chase it. See if all these pre-market buyers liquidate at the open, establish a new area of support. I should say a higher area of support, and look to take a trade there at that spot. Also got First Solar. Anything up above $70 is a buy, and COGT. There goes the bell. See how it holds up. If it can hold up above this 570, then that will definitely be in play. Most of these companies are popping based off of either developing a blockchain or developing a coin to receive payment or put out on the market. So that's the new fad nowadays, having your own coin, having your own blockchain. Seems like that's the new fad. So we'll let AMRH open up, see what it's going to do. Hemi's HMNY is pulling back a little bit now. So is Kodak. Pulling back a little bit. We'll go from there. Not gonna chase this right here. Be patient. Don't try to catch a falling knife. You will get stabbed to death every time. So I'm gonna grab some HMNY. I'm sorry, some XNET. Right here, 2322. Some long XNET. Feel it at 2318. Alright, some long XNET at 2318. Stop at the open of this long candle here. So Kodak looks like it's found some support. If it can hold this, what's this, 1279, I'll jump into Kodak. Still holding XNET. Got my stop right here, 2279. I'm long from 2319. And let me get some Kodak. So I'm buying 3,000 shares of Kodak. Let's see, all right. Boom. So I'm long Kodak right here at 305. There's XNET, finally. Getting back up to my entry. Now it's trying to do something. So I got my stop for Kodak at 1237. XNET's up to 2325, I'm long 2318. Long Kodak, 1305. All right, so let me get out of this Kodak. XNET's up 2343. I'll sell roughly 500 shares up to around 2350. And I'm about to take a loss on this code. It's not happening. Alright, so I lost, what, 2,400 on Kodak. Looks like it's gonna be a short. I got 2,000 shares on XNet. Go ahead and sell it 500 on XNet. Move my stop up to break even. So I have to walk away with $2,400 loss on Kodak. XNet's looking great, so I'll continue to hold those 1,500 shares. I'll probably sell another 5 up there, 24. This line represents yesterday's close. So we back above yesterday's close, which is a good thing. 500 gold on XNet, 2404. Got 1,000 shares left, I'm long from 2318. It's 946. I'm gonna take 5 contracts short on ES minis, break below this trend line. So I'm going to sell 5 contracts right there, 2741.50. XNet 2424. Looking good on ES futures, short nose, break below that pre-market trend. 5 contracts short from 2741. First target would be 2737. Sell another 500 shares of XNet. Yes, down to 2740.39. So that's great. XNet's looking good. Did take a loss on this Kodak. That trade didn't work out well. I'll let 2 contracts run down here, 2737. So you put them on, that'd be my first target. XNet's not pulling back, so I would just move the stop up. All right, so let me sell 3 contracts down here. We'll buy back 3 contracts on ES. Lock in some money on that. So XNet 24.99. So we now will probably get that 5-minute setup. Get rid of some of these lines. Move this. Move that. That's my original entry. This is my current stop. 2417. She might be a little tight. It might be. Get a little bounce in ES futures. Put my stop at break even, which is 2741.50. Only have 2 contracts left. All right, flatten out of this X net. All right, so 1700 on X net. We'll wait for a first 5 minute setup. So I'm still holding this ES Future short. Stop is 2741.50. It. All right, let me flatten out ES. All right, so I'm out of ES trade, made 562 on it. So I'm still down 122 for the day. XNet was a good trade, ES was a good trade, Kodak did not work out well. Lost 2400 on it. So I'm gonna grab some JNUG at 1707. And I'll put my stop right here at 1683. JNUG had a gap up overnight, stock pulled back a little bit pre-market. People took profits first 10 minutes of trading, and the stock pushed back up, pushed back through the open, and now it's making a new high for the day. So my target will be this pre-market high. Be my first target. It's a good trade setup. JNUG to the top. JNUG still gaining a little profit there. It's up to 1718, long from 1708. Sell 1,000 up there at 1728 to take me back to break even on the day. Let the last 2,000 shares ride out, see how far it can take us. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and sell 1,000 shares of JNUG here at 1726 and keep 2,000 left on the table. Move my stop to break even. All right, so JNUG still looking good, 1723. Got 2,000 shares left on it. All right, JNUG is about to break pre-market highs, which is great. All right, there's the break of a pre-market high, JNUG. Volume can increase. Stock could push up to 1750. And I'll sell another 1,000 up there. Just need volume to pick up. Nice size seller right there at 1736. See if he gets ate up. I'm gonna sell 1730. So I sold another 1730. Right to 1740, 1730 area is going to be area of resistance. So I got 1,000 left. Keep my stop right here at 1717. Long from 1708. Where I Alright, so it looks like I'm going to be stopped out of this JNUG. Alright, so that's it for me today. Made it back to the green. Took some hard work, but made it back. Took a big loss on this Kodak. Like I said, 2400. Took an entry right here at 1305. And the stock proceeded to sell off. Ended up getting stopped out. 3,000 shares on Kodak. So I guess the lesson I can take from this would be waiting until price either breaks above one of these two highs, either it's 1328, 1326, versus just breaking above this pre-market high. Because if it broke above pre-market high right here, then fell back down, back to this trend line, ideal scenario would be to wait till it breaks above this established high. Since obviously this area is an area of resistance, price dropped very hard right here. So I guess that's my takeaway for Kodak. Don't have tunnel vision on these pre-market highs. This intraday high is probably a little bit more realistic as a resistance area. So Kodak was the big loss. XNet was a big gainer. Took a long trade with the break above this trend line. Stock pushed higher, fell back, didn't hit my stop. Then stock shot off. And I scaled out as it went up. And ended up closing out the position around 24. I think I closed around 24.18, I believe. I think I was long from 23.18. So that was a good trade on XNet. ES short was also a good trade this morning before it bounced. It also broke through this trend line, took it short, closed out three contracts down here, then the stock pushed back up, hit my stop, and I let the last two go. So back in the green today, closing out the day up $347. So that's better than taking that $2,000 loss. Kodak. But at the same time, learn a lesson for Kodak. Get better with those entries. So that's it for me today. I'm the Bearded Trader.